And the woman's daughter was healed from that house. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated, brothers and sisters. The theme which we will see in all the readings today, from the first reading to the responsorial psalm, to the second reading and the gospel, is about the universality of God's love. That God's love, it's not exclusive to one group of people, but God's love is inclusive. It includes everyone. All the three readings speak of the expansive. It's widening. It's expansive. And the universal nature of the kingdom of God. In contrast with the theory that salvation was offered first to the Jews and through them, then to the rest of the world. Although God set the Hebrew people apart as a chosen race, from the beginning, He already included all nations in His plan for salvation and blessed all the families of the earth in Abraham and through Abraham. In fact, the blessing to Abraham is a blessing to all the nations who believe. In the first reading, by declaring through the prophet Isaiah, he said, "My house shall be called a house of prayer for all peoples." We see here already that it is not just for His own people, but for all peoples, the house of God, a place of encounter between God and man, is for all peoples of all walks of life, all race or color. God reveals the truth that in His eyes, there is no distinction among human beings on the basis of race or color. The long-expected Messiah was intended not only for the Jews, but for all nations as well, breaking from the traditional thought of earlier prophets. Isaiah's words today have God speaking about salvation reaching out beyond the chosen. At a time, even until today, the Jews believe that they are a chosen race. But then from the beginning, especially through Isaiah, we see His plan of salvation goes beyond the chosen people to the foreigners who join themselves to the Lord. For the majority of their history, even among today, the people of Israel believed that God had only blessed and chosen their nation. It was for them inconceivable. They could not think that God could extend His divine love to any other nations. They could not think or even imagine. Oh, they heard that God promised Abraham that all people would be blessed through his offspring. But they did not think that God's unconditional love could reach other peoples the same way that it touched them, their lives. The scriptures that God was not only the God of Israel, but that the Lord of all nations and all peoples who are willing to come before the Lord and worship God. Today's responsorial psalm rejects all types of religious exclusivity. It says, "Let all the peoples praise you, O God, for you judge the people with equity and guide the nations upon the earth, so that your saving power may be known among all the nations." And we have the response which echoes the theme, "O God, let all the nations praise you." It reiterates the theme of all nations rejoicing in the salvation of God. It portrays a time when all people will live in harmony and equality because God is God over all. But here we see from the first reading to the responsorial psalm that God's love is not exclusive, cannot be limited to one group of people. But the truth is, God's love is always expansive, widening, reaching out. I remember an SVD theologian, Father Steve Bevans, who said that God is better seen as a verb, not as a noun. God is a movement more personal than we can ever imagine, who is always and everywhere present in God's creation, present in the warp and woof of it, working for creation's wholeness and healing. God's deepest identity is a relationship, a communion, calling all of creation according to its capacity into that communion. And once in that communion, He sends forth creation to gather still more of it into communion. And He added, "It's like a dance." And He recalled this African dance, which is expansive. That means it's going out, gathering people who are in the outside, bringing them in. And then once they are in the communion together, He sends them out again. And they gather other people they found on their way, bringing them in again, making the circle bigger and wider. That is the description from the scripture today. Love is expansive. Love is universal. Communion is expansive. It's never limited. It's never exclusive. It is all-inclusive. In the second reading, St. Paul once again demonstrates that he has compassion and concern for both the Gentiles and the people from whom he came, the Jews. As he sees it, the blessings one promised to the chosen people have been handed over to the non-Jews because the people of Israel had refused to accept the truth of Jesus as Messiah and Son of God. This opened the door for the Gentiles to be reconciled with God. Paul's hope and prayers is that someday the faith of the Gentiles will touch the heart of the Jewish people so that they would accept the forgiveness and mercy of God and the reconciliation and salvation earned by the death and resurrection of Jesus. So here again, we can picture in our mind that African dance that would go out from the circle, bring others together gathering them into that circle. And then once in their circle, they go out again. Here in the second reading, we see that the small circle was the Jewish. But then the message of Jesus goes out and bringing, including the Gentiles, bringing in and enriching that circle, that those Jews who are hesitant, reluctant to receive Jesus may experience His mercy from the witnessing of the Gentiles, would accept the forgiveness and mercy of God. Beautiful imagery of this expansive and the universal aspect of God's love. In the gospel today, Jesus is being sought by a Gentile woman who wants Jesus to heal her daughter. Jesus' initial response to the woman may seem a bit harsh. In fact, it's not just harsh. At first, he ignored her. Then he called her a dog. Very insulting. And after that, she told her that it's not good to give the food that is reserved for the children to the dogs. Such an insult. And yet the woman persisted, humbled herself, and made a beautiful declaration of her faith in Jesus. She said, "Lord, even the dogs would be so content to eat the scraps that fell from the table. It's enough for them. The scraps that fell from the table would be enough for them." And the Lord marveled at her faith. Very humble, but very profound understanding about God's grace and mercy, which cannot be limited to the table. But even the scraps would be enough for people like her. And because of that, there was a change of the Lord's the understanding of her, of His mission. That His mission includes not only the Jewish people or limited to the area or geographical place, but it includes even the Gentiles. With persistence of faith, the woman responded to the challenge of Jesus. Turning to the woman, Jesus commends her faith and promises healing for her daughter. The first lesson I learned from the gospel today is the word persistence in prayer. Many years ago, in Illinois, Chicago, a young man with 6 months formal schooling to his credit ran for an office in the legislature. As might have been expected, he was beaten. Hindi nanalo. Next, he entered business but failed in that too, and spent the next 17 years paying the debts of his worthless partner. He fell in love with a charming lady. They became engaged. She got sick and died, causing her lover a mini nervous breakdown. He ran for Congress and was defeated. He then tried to obtain an appointment to the U.S. Land Office, but didn't succeed. He became a candidate for the vice presidency, but lost. 2 years later, he was defeated in the race for the Senate. Finally, he ran for president, and finally, he was elected. Do you know who that man was? His name is Abraham Lincoln. So imagine, For the many times that he failed, different offices he applied, he ran for Congress, he ran for Senate, he ran for Vice Presidency, failed. Even his personal life, his wife died, he had depression, nervous breakdown, but still he persisted. He persevered. He did not abandon his dreams, his goals. And finally, he won the presidency in the United States of America. So Abraham Lincoln. Today's gospel presents a Canaanite woman who persisted in her prayer and obtained from the Lord what she prayed for. Persistence in our prayer. Then secondly, we learn from that Canaanite woman. We just be humble. Humble ourselves. Then plead with Jesus. And tell Jesus, Lord, even the scraps would be enough for me. Would be enough for my family. Would be enough for my loved ones. Lord, your blessing, Lord. Maybe you are giving that to some people. But for me, Lord, just a scrap of your blessings would be enough. Kahit isang maliit lang, Panginoon, na nahuhulog, that would be enough for me, Lord. That kind of faith of the Canaanite woman would be very powerful in touching the heart of God, touching the heart of Jesus. And Jesus responded positively to the Canaanite woman. He will also respond positively to our pleadings, including to our persistence. Never give up. Never surrender. Never quit. Hold on to the Lord. The challenge I have today is to know that God's love is not exclusive. Sometimes I am tempted to call him my God, my Father, my Jesus. The pronoun my. As if I possess God, I possess Jesus, I possess his blessings. Anytime I can go to him and say, my Father, my Jesus, I want to have this. I have problems. Give me this. Give me that. I have to remind myself first of all that God's love is inclusive. It includes everyone, especially the least expected people. Those people who are in the streets, they are unknown, they are nobody. Nobody remembers them. Nobody even cares for them. Nobody even dares to approach them. Nobody even gives respect to them. To them, they are also included in God's love, in God's plan. So, one thing, it reminds me that God's love is not exclusive for me alone. Secondly, it also tells me that God's love is not only for those who are good persons, who are faithful persons, who are believers, who are holy. At sino ba naman ako, Panginoon, na bigyan mo ng pansin? I'm not holy. I'm not good. I'm not faithful. I'm not always strong in my belief. To you, the Lord will also say, my love includes you. To those who believe that they are not worthy, that they are not deserving of God's love, to you belongs his love. So brothers and sisters, we rejoice when the Lord calls us, brings us to the circle, and then he will send us again to find other people. Tell them what the Lord did to us, the wonders God has done for us. Then bring them back to the circle, and God will send them out again as He will send us forth to bring more people, and the circle of communion will be widening, widening, widening. Let's have the attitude of the Canaanite woman, persistence in prayer. Secondly, you don't have to ask for big blessings, miracles. Even the scraps of blessings would be enough for us. Amen. Please rise. We profess our faith to God as we say, and believe in one God, Creator of heaven and earth,
and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages.